research. There is an international research e-conference organized by our scientific partner, Indian Clinical Research Association, ICRA, under the leadership of Dr. Muhammad Siddiq and also Professor Arunachalam Ramachandran in the organizing committee. Research is for PhD, research is for masters, research can be for undergraduate projects, research can be clinical research performed by consultants, and research can be performed by full-time researchers who are doing for the funded projects under the government or the private organizations. Everybody is doing research, and in physical therapy, the profession of physiotherapy itself has grown over this past 130 years. It's only very young, okay? So this year it has grown this phenomenally, and other professions are looking at us with insecurity. It's mainly because of the advancements of knowledge which is brought about by research. When undergraduate students do research, they have A to Z everything as questions, okay? Because we don't expect the curriculum in undergraduate to provide an adequate foundation for research. But if you could get the best guidance, their project will be recognized globally. They will be able to publish in acceptable standard journals, and their conference presentations will be worthwhile when they are doing an interdisciplinary exchange of information. Because when a physical therapist is presenting, orthopedician may be chairing the session, although it is a BPT student. So they should see that BPT students are presenting this extent. Then only their respect for physiotherapy profession will improve. Okay. So we should actually involve every profession, and that's the only way by which we grow. Even in research also, authors should be from multiple disciplines, okay, of their own expertise. In this series, AYMPT, the Academy of Orthopedic Manual Physical Therapists, has launched the Student Meets Expert, the series. It can be for case discussions. This can be for topics discussions, okay, like theoretical, a set of 10 topics which they want to clarify. Or it can be the research project which the student is doing. So you have multiple options. Or maybe just like an interview, if the student wants to clarify the professional issues and things which their teachers are giving controversial answers, okay? Or they want to get more and more controversies by listening to my answers, for example, okay? Ultimately, life will be transformed. Okay, so that's guaranteed. Because in AYMPT, we are always concerned more on the future. Okay, if this is one thing that we can repair, it's only the future. And why we can do that only by handling the present population, okay, the targets. So people should come forward. And we had the first part of this session taken by Mr. Rishab. He is an osteopathy student, and we had the discussion. The first part of the discussion involves, it was in Zoom, and it involved that the planning of the research, okay, that before beginning. Today, he is going to present the proposal of the research protocol, okay, what he is actually going to do in a structured format. And he has got the assistance from the AYMPT, he has got some articles, he has got inputs. The last session was more than 1 hour, and that video is uploaded on the AYMPT official Instagram. But remember that, you know, these sessions involve registrations. You involve and then you register, and then you get the e-certificate for attending also. Okay, you get to know an idea of how a research project is actually made, okay, and how that student's questions or queries, how we are able to address, okay, what is the feedback that all of us could provide, so that the research becomes the best. So in that dimension, today, in just in a minute at Zoom, Mr. Rishab is presenting the part 2 of his research project, and I have seen the PowerPoint, and he has done phenomenal work. Okay, he he might tell that he's got guidance from the best academy and he did it really well. But I will tell you, teachers don't determine the future until and unless the students take the future in their own hands. Okay? Student empowerment is the first step to a transformation for the future. If students feel responsible, you don't require a teacher. Mark my word. Okay? A one teacher, if he is the best, if he is teaching 100 students, all 100 has to become the best. But it never happens. Only 10 students become the best. Why? Because those 10 students determined that I have to become best. So ultimately, this is the student's hand. So don't think that you are made best because of a teacher or you are nothing because there is no teacher. And don't ever believe that the college resources is the end of life. Because you always have the online method, which the COVID and the lockdown has shown that it is, there is no geographical restrictions at all when it comes to knowledge. And you have the AYMPT with you definitely. Not only for the student members, it's also for the non-members. Any student who's in BPT or related healthcare discipline can actually register and involve in these sessions to clarify their academic, clinical and research queries. So coming to this session, we are eager to go and begin the session there. So I just came here to just to announce the launch of the session, and interested people, please contact me and register at a nominal fee. You get a certificate of presentation. It's like certification of appreciation, okay, actually. And also, you will be eligible for a cashback if your performance is impressive and you did a sincere work, maintained the time deadlines and things. So you will get a reward as a cashback. Maybe the fees itself will be refunded, or you might get even more than that. Okay. So just make your step, and your destiny is all yours. Good luck to you all. Welcome all the students to come forward and engage in these presentations. So we have amongst us Dr. Ritu ma'am and Dr. Mansi as the external reviewers. Why I am not including as a reviewer myself is because I have already given inputs to Rishabh. I will give inputs now also, but we want some extra inputs so that we can make the project better. And wishing good luck to Mr. Rishabh Agarwal, our beloved AYMPT member, who's made an excellent first part of the presentation to conceptualize a research project. Today he's presenting the PowerPoint and the discussions for the slides before submitting to the college. Okay, so he's yet to submit to the college and present it in front of the ethics committee. Okay. So opening words from Dr. Ritu and then by Dr. Mansi.
Yes, sir. Yes, good ma'am. Evening, sir. Good evening, all. Good evening, Rishabh ji. Good luck for your best work about that research topic you have chosen, and you are doing research with the guidance of AYMPT and your hard work, which will show us a right way. This is a very different topic from for me. It is very different. So I want to learn more about all these things also, because if we are studying, we are learning. So we should not leave this topic also, because maybe in future I will walk on this way. So it's our pleasure to listen to you. So it's a very important thing which we're missing in my part. So I want to learn more and more about your presentation. And sir is also here for guidance for all of us. So good luck to you, Mr. Rishabh.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
It's my pleasure.
Good evening, sir. Good evening, Rishabh. Good evening, Rishabh, ma'am. Namaste.
Hi, Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, ma'am. All the best to you, and we are here to learn. We are here to learn new things. And every day there is a post, I mean, this joint, that joint, shoulder joint, ankle joint. But today, last 2 days, it was something different, hypothyroidism and constipation. So we're like, we have to attend this. We have to see what's going
Definitely.
On. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much, sir. And Rishabh, all the best.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah. Thank you. All the best. Thank you. Thank you.
Over to Rishabh. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Take over.
Yes, sir. So, good evening to everyone. So, the topic for my research project that I have chosen is the effect of osteopathic treatment on constipation in hypothyroid patient. So, the table of content is divided into 7 pages, like this: introduction, objectives, literature review, methodology, tools, data analysis, and finally the reference. So, coming to the research question, the main idea I had while thinking about this topic was that, like in the screen, you can see that the intestinal motility and serum TSS levels are closely related, and hypothyroidism reduces the intestinal motility and leads to constipation. So the main area of focus for me was like, can osteopathy be used to treat constipation in hypothyroid patient? So in this present study, I have intended to know what will be the effect of osteopathic manipulation in treating constipation on hypothyroid patient in the age group of 20 to 40 years. So the background, let's know first about what's hypothyroidism. Hypothyroidism is a disorder in which the thyroid glands does not produce enough thyroid hormones. There are numerous types of symptoms related to hypothyroidism. It could be poor ability to tolerate cold, feeling of tiredness, slow heart rate, depression, weight gain, and constipation being one of the symptoms of hypothyroidism. Thyroid hormones plays an important role in several organs and plays a vital role in overall health of the body. Thyroid dysfunction can have a negative effect on the gut motility and bowel movement. Constipation, according to the National Institute of Diabetes and Digestive and Kidney Disease, tells us that it is like 15% of individuals have fewer than 3 bowel movement each week. Constipation, it's not a disease, but it's rather a symptom from the another medical problems. What's constipation? Constipation is a condition in which a person has a fewer than 3 bowel movement every week, hard, dry, or lumpy stools that are difficult or painful to pass, and a sense that not all stool had passed. Hypothyroidism mainly slows down all the body systems, including digestion and elimination, and chronic constipation is a result of one of it. There are numerous studies that have been done on the constipation. There is a retrospective study shows that the visceral osteopathy for constipation has reduced the length of hospitalization in hypothyroid patient. Even some studies have shown that the osteopathic manipulation in treatment of chronic constipation have shown a reduction in constipation symptoms, laxative use, chronic transmit time, and overall improvement in quality of life. The main general objective for my study is to find out the effect of osteopathic treatment on constipation in hypothyroid patient. The specific objective of this study is divided into 3: to study the effect of osteopathy in balancing the TSS level in hypothyroid patient. Second point, to study the effect of osteopathy in constipation scoring system. Third, to find out the pre and post intervention of osteopathic treatment in constipation on hypothyroid patient. Literature review. The Andrew Steele have in his quote tells us, a halt has come, the bowel have failed in their function, the power to pass out fecal matter is caused off overall from all some cause. In this literature review, Unnikrishnan, AG, ATL have found that the thyroid disease is common around the world. According to its projection, thyroid disease studies, its estimate around 42 million people in India suffers from thyroid disease. Kia and Dean ETL found that 30% of hypothyroid patients showed symptoms related to bowel dysfunction after having thyroid dysfunction. As Prustriono ATL in their study found that the patient with hypothyroidism may have autonomic nervous dysfunction, which leads to the decrease in vagal influence and later decrease the motility of intestine, leading to decrease in bowel movement. Bia Budo, in also in his article, referred about hypothyroidism to cause hypomotility, intestinal atonicity, and pseudo obstruction of intestine. Poonam Singh has referred yoga to be helping hypothyroidism patient and treating the disease related symptoms, being constipation one of them. In her report, she has taken 20 hypothyroid females and they were allowed to take 1 hour yoga session for at least 1 month. The recommended yoga pranayam included all the 7 yoga pranayams that can be seen in the screen. Dr. S. Vinuda, in a study, shows that 90 days of Ujjayi pranayam reduced TSH level and T3 level, and no significant difference in T4. This shows that the yoga practice has a significant role in improvement with the weight reduction and relieving constipation. Diet has been a major thing for the hypothyroidism and constipation. And Madeline Ardvan, in her article, refers about eating more fiber-rich foods like fruits with skin on, vegetables, berries, beans, and whole grains, which could help with constipation by adding bulk to stool and help to pass more quickly through the intestine. Before treating constipation, we would like to seek the basic explanation for the matter and hypothyroidism being one of the explanation for constipation. Would like to treat the thyroid issues first. Dana, in her article, referred the thyroid relation with the spine. If one feature of thyroid problem that produce swelling, the swelling might cause a vertebrae in your spine to protrude or subluxate with the cervical spine. The thyroid is related to C7 vertebrae. The RATL in his study found that the common abnormalities associated with thyroids are cervical spine, upper thoracic, upper ribs, clavicle, and associate muscular attachment. Dee Cortiel, in his detection and management of hypothyroidism, suggested that manipulative treatment for hypothyroidism should also include reduction of restriction of connective tissues and soft tissue to optimize systemic response to the thyroid. Fabio Scopa, in article, showed that type 1 glossopostural syndromes in patient end in combination of short upper trapezius, weak neck flexors, shortened pectoral, and weak lower trapezius and serratus muscle, plus low paravertebral muscles, and weak abdominal muscles. And people with weak abdominal muscles have abdominal dysfunctions and constipation being one of it. In the book, Visceral and Obstetric Osteopathy, Caroline Stone refers osteopathic treatment to the abdominal viscera, particularly the large intestine and the small colon, has been advocated for the treatment of chronic constipation and aims to improve the bowel function, influencing the smooth muscle tone and improving the visceral mobility and motility. Bergman, RETL, in the study shows that the treatment techniques in each study included mobilization of thoracolumbar spine, sacropelvic area for the treatment of constipation. The treatment of psoas major is commonly described the treatment for constipation. Sarah Cole, ETL, in their study tells that the cranial manipulation has great impact in constipation in hypothyroid patient. The mean duration of the time reported was 30 to 40 minutes. Kuchera ML, in his book, mentioned that the right-sided colon dysfunction is seen in the OA, AA, and at occipitomastoid suture region and generally examined and manipulated. in the right occipital area, more tissues dysfunction is predicted because the right vagus nerve innervates the right colon. The clinician should palpate the iliotibial band in people with constipation for diagnostic anterior Chapman point that might indicate colon irritation. With kneading and stretching soft tissue therapy, the lumbothoracic and lumbosacral regions are then relaxed. In all the diseases related to colon, it may be related that the lymphatic congestion of the colon, checking for the facial torsion and joint stomatic dysfunction at the thoracic inlet as the initial step towards improving the lymphatic drainage. And diaphragm plays an important role in order to provide an effective pressure gradient needed to pump the lymph from abdomen to thorax. Tarsal TATL in the study included that 30 children with cerebral palsy were diagnosed with constipation. One study group received OTM, which is the osteopathic manipulative treatment, which included fascia release, iliopsoas release, sphincter release, and bowel mobilization, while the other group received OMT and medical therapy. Both groups had 6 treatment over 1 month. Subject had significant improvement in symptom severity, chronic transmit time, and quality of life. So this is the methodology. So the study design is a pre-test, post-test experimental design. The sample size will be calculated once the population size is finalized, and the minimum sample size is around 30. The sampling technique, it would be a convenient sampling which will be used for selecting the sample for the study. The source of the subject, the subjects will be chosen from the Sri Sri University campus and nearby area around Cuttack and Orissa. The inclusion criteria for this is the both the genders, male and female, will be included, age between 20 to 40 years, patient with hypothyroidism with constipation problem, patient with type 1 or type 2 criteria in Bristol stool form, and scale patient with Moore-Wexner constipation score. Exclusion criteria, pregnant woman, cardiac patient, psychiatric patient, diabetic mellitus patient, major neurological patient, contraindications of osteopathic manipulation. Independent variable, osteopathic treatment comprising of cranial, musculoskeletal, and visceral techniques. And dependent variable would be the TSH level and constipation scoring. So the procedure goes like that. There'll be an assessment of eligibility, then there'll be initially a recruitment, there'll be a questionnaire, there'll be a pre-test, intervention, osteopathic intervention, there'll be a post-test, data analysis, and final analysis. So in the procedure, the minimum 30 subjects will be enrolled for the study. 30 patients suffering from the constipation and hypothyroidism will, with a regular dose of thyroxine, will be enrolled. Patient will be interviewed, and based on the inclusion and exclusion criteria, patient will be chosen for the experimental group. The experimental group and control group will have to undergo the pre-test TS level and fill up a questionnaire. The questionnaires will be related to the PAC QOL, that is the patient with constipation, quality of life, Bristol stool chart, and the Wexner constipation scoring. Out of 30, 15 patients will be given 5 to 6 sessions in duration of 2 months, along with their normal doses for thyroxine. That will be the experimental group. And the remaining 15 patients will be given a regular dosage of thyroxine, that is the control group. The total patient will be evaluated with the proper demographic data, clinical history, physical examination, with a proper scoring for constipation and TSH level pre and post intervention. So this is the sessions I have, protocol I have made. So there'll be 6 sessions that I'll be giving for at least 2 months. And the session 1 would include the fascia release. Session 2 would include muscle energy technique. 3 will be sympathetic treatment. 4th would be lymphatic drainage. Session 5 would be visceral manipulation. And session 6 would be parasympathetic treatment. In the lower photo, you can see that the parasympathetic, what is the importance of parasympathetic treatment? Parasympathetic treatment would improve the motility. It could increase the secretion and decrease the pain. sympathetic attenuates the stimulus for the GI organs and normalize the autonomic function. Importance of lymphatics, it could improve the venous and lymphatic congestion, improves removal of toxic waste. And abdominal manipulation, a visceral manipulation, it could improve the chronic transit time, it could improve the stool frequency and decrease pain and bloating. So these are the techniques that I'll be using for my treatment, which is based on all the six sessions. Like there'll be lessening of hyoid bone, they could be hyoid release, there would be cavicle release, then the sternum release, there's the and the thoracic outlet, that is for the lymphatic drainage, diaphragm pump for the lymphatic drainage, pedal pump for the lymphatic drainage, and we'll go for the cervical lymphatic drainage, mandibular lymph drainage, submandibular lymph drainage. Then there'll be a musculoskeletal release, that will be the thoracolumbar stretch. Then there'll be visceral manipulation, that would be the abdominal release, cecum lift and sigmoid lift. And for the sympathetic and parasympathetic, sympathetic we'll use for, I'll use rib raising, and for parasympathetic, I'll use sacrum and lumbar listening and occipito-atlantic decompression. The tools that I'll be using is first, there'll be a lab. I'll be allocating all the students who will be there to go to the near hospital to go for the lab test for the TSS level test. And there'll be data collection form. There'll be Wexner constipation scoring, Bristol stool chart, and patient with constipation quality of life questionnaires. So the Wexner constipation scoring system is their chart, where all the 8 questions are there, 32 points. The maximum is the 30, which will relate to chronic constipation. And there is the Bristol stool chart, where you can see that they are type 7 of kind, from ranging from severe constipation to severe diarrhea. So patient will be scored according to this. And the data analyzing tools that I'll be using for my research would be the Microsoft Excel data analysis tool, SPSS, statistical package for the social science. And this is the reference which I have to all the this article from, and this is the PPT.
Can you show the reference slide again?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
I have Italian and French abstracts. The next reference slide. See, note down this. Brugman.
Yes, sir.
This article citation is correct format. Okay?
Yes, sir.
You don't need a DOI. You don't need a October or November, all this. Okay? Volume, yes, number. Like, for example, Mavilia, Mariana, the one which follows.
Yes, sir.
The volume issue, that words are not needed. You have to remove that according to the Brugman format. Okay.
Okay, sir. Yes, sir.
In the Word document, have you numbered the references?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. So, if it would be seen, wait, sir. I'll okay. Show the Word also.
No, it's fine. No problem.
Okay, sir.
What's important is use the same numbering here. Okay?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Sure, sir.
The Word document will be the printed format which the faculty will be having. Okay?
Okay, sir. Yes, sir.
Another is the slides handout which they'll be having if you are asked to submit that. Okay?
Okay. Yes, sir.
So, when they see that both, it should be same reference number. Sentences may not be fully there in the PowerPoint. You can include only 5 sentences in introduction. The number will be like number 15, number 22, okay, in the PowerPoint.
Okay. Yes, sir.
In Word document, it will start with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, sequentially.
Mm-hmm. Okay, sir. So,
okay. So, we will get some inputs now first from Dr. Mansi. Because what I believe is, if I ask Dr. Mansi in the end, she will tell, Ritu ma'am already told, are you already told all this? So I want to get that first-hand perspective. Okay, when you attended the presentation, did you get an idea of what he's doing? Okay, and some techniques names are familiar. Some of the techniques which actually we are yet to explore because it is the osteopathy domain, the core of osteopathy. Okay, so we are not going into the technical skill or the expertise because we are expecting him to be getting trained by international faculty. Okay, so they have faculty who are visiting the Sri Sri University, and he is also an active learner. Okay, he will get certified with every technique that is required. Okay, you don't have to tell him at all. So, at an appropriate stage of his career, I will say it's not just studenthood, because you develop your career from the studentship. Okay, and at the early stage of career, he joined the AOMPT. So what is important here is about the research. Although we may not have any experience in research, but still, are you understanding that what actually is going on and what is the actual presentation and what are your clarifications that you can put it forward? Yes, Dr. Mansi.
Yes, sir. Actually, he explained it quite well. I could understand. I could link it actually. He has gone step by step. What is hypothyroidism, then the autonomic dysfunction, and then the vagus obstruction that happens. Then he went on to yoga, that how it is helping. He went on to the dietary factor. And he also mentioned about other studies which they have done about the manipulations, the osteopathic manipulation. So he has been backed up with references. So that is good enough. And what all procedure, the fascia release, with the help of photographs, I think he has mentioned it well. So I could understand it, whatever was happening, unless and until I see the procedure, it will be, more better for me actually. But I didn't understand the cervical connection actually. It is only because of the vagus because thoracic, I can understand autonomic dysfunction. The cervical thing I couldn't understand. Why is it connected?
So, ma'am, the cervical spine is related to like the vagus nerve connection. It starts from the jugular foramen and it passes through the cervical spine and goes towards the abdomen, and from the thorax, it goes to the abdomen. So if there is any subluxation of the C7 or the atlas, or there is any rotation of the atlas, or if there is any subluxation, or there is any compression of the this cervical vertebrae, that could compress the musculature, and it could even affect the vagal tone around the those area, and that vagal tone can be seen in the patient suffering from with thyroid disease also, and even with numerous diseases. Like there would be an example in this case, like I would see that when there is a swelling in thyroid patient, you can see that the neck circumference is increasing. What happens in this is there is more of sympathetic and less of parasympathetic in this. So what happens that the if while treating this at last, while occipital atlanto decompression, we are releasing the occiput with condyle, and we are releasing the suture, we are releasing the atlas from the occiput, and there is a passage between the that the jugular foramen is not compressed in this case. So there I have referred about the posture analysis also, where the Fabio Scapo has released that a type 1 glossopharyngeal glosso postural syndrome. what happens in this, there's the upper area, upper muscles, which are related to this thyroid disease, plays an important role in for the this connection related to hypothyroidism. And it can comprise the all the vagus nerve, like the parasympathetic nerve, like the right colon. It's related to the right vagus nerve that is coming from the directly from the jugular foramen, and the sacrum treatment is from the, we'll do the sacrum rocking movement, like we'll go for the anterior and the posterior compression test in this one, and activating the parasympathetic response in this. So each and everything is related, is connected in this study, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
All good, sir. Otherwise, all good. I had that doubt. Thank you so much. And
just remind me about the sympathetic parasympathetic. Okay.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
The extension of what Dr. Mansi had asked. Now it's over to Dr. Vithuman.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, sir. It was a nice presentation as you started with the yoga, because I have seen many people who are curing their thyroid problem with the yoga exercise. Like you mentioned that there is a Ujjayini pranam which really helps to activate that glands, that, and the people who suffer from long time.
I'm interrupting.
Yes.
Rishab, are you giving yoga?
No, sir. I'll be prescribing yoga, sir. I will tell them, because
yoga.
Yes, sir. So because in our university we have this art of living courses where
okay,
all
so
the
in
students
addition
are
to yoga.
Yes, sir.
So you like, are saying in terms of already medications are there for hypothyroidism or constipation.
Yes, sir.
Or both, and already yoga is there.
Yes,
and
sir.
And an effect of the osteopathic treatment.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, Ritu ma'am, proceed. Continue.
Yes, sir. So Ujjayini pranayam is really creates a very very good role, as well as for the constipation of people. We do some exercise like cobra stretching, cobra pose, and then especially that Pavana Muktasana. That is also very, all the patients who are suffering with the constipation, we prescribe them that asana also. That also gives. As well as if we, in our language, we use the core strengthening, the same in the yoga language, we do the all stretching. It is all same, because we are in your osteopathy also, that liftment of the diaphragm, that exercise, that technique is there. And the craniosacral therapy, that is also very useful, which you have already shown. And we already learned that technique from our sir. That how we can activate that cranium and throw the sacrum. So these all points are very real, really works it. So I have a one question, that if the person, if a girl...
I think I have one interruption, one more. Yes, Rishabh, sir. Is not included in craniosacral therapy.
No, sir. He is no, not sir. Included. He was just showing that cranial effect. Like I am combined about our AMPT session. How you have shown us that craniosacral therapy as a, in our osteopathy webinar. So my question, if that girl, 15 years girl, she is facing a severe constipation problem. She spent 1 hour in a washroom, and after that she says, my stomach is not clear. Although she is taking fibers, lots of water. So is there any connection with the thyroid also? So we have to go further investigation of thyroid also. I just wanted to know about his.
Yes, ma'am. Because thyroid has an important role in playing for the gut motility, as I have referred. So
yeah,
what happens in it? What happens in this? It reduces the gut motility. They decreases the intestinal motility. The bowel movement has been reduced due to the TSH level. So there, here comes the sympathetic and parasympathetic, which comes into play. So there is hyperactive sympathetic response and less parasympathetic response. So here comes the osteopathic manipulation, which will help, like the rib raising, which I told, which I referred. Like we'll release the ribs area, because the ribs are attached, like the tip of the ribs has these ganglions, when we'll do the myofascial release or the rebracing, these ganglions will be activated while doing it. So the sympathetic response also will be released. And for the parasympathetic, we are using the atlantal decompression and the sacral rocking, because the root cause, where is the root cause arising from? It is from the ganglions.
Occipito-atlantal decompression is craniosacral.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Sacral rocking. Even the sacral rocking is the thing which will be used. That will do the sacrum listening also, and this which will activate the parasympathetic. That is the pelvic
all that listening procedures are the craniosacral.
Yes, sir.
Right. And one thing you have mentioned, that IT band for that
yes, ma'am.
Combination,
yes, ma'am.
With IT band. So please, little bit explanation. I want
to learn. Ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Sure. So there is a sign like the Chapman. There is a Chapman point where we can refer this. Like there is a chart which I'd shown also in my literature review. It's not there, I think so. But there is a chart. I would like to share that later, right now also, if it's possible. So if may I show that point, sir? One, sir.
Yeah. Go ahead.
Okay, sir.
Apparently, as the slide is getting loaded, can I ask Dr. Ritu ma'am that what are the asanas for diarrhea?
So no asana for diarrhea. No one can stop this. only the tablet, that Roco tablet can contract only.
Yes,
you can practice Moola Bandha.
That is good, ma'am. But when the diarrhea is there, no Moola Bandha. not even throat to stomach to our navi to anus. No Moola Bandha works in that case. You can't do this. I have used
okay,
all
Rishab, these. Continue.
So Ritu ma'am, this is the Chapman reflexes which refers to this area. So like the patient with constipation, like the Chapman discovered this areas where palpating those areas, it is like there is a trigger point areas, you can say it, but it is very hypersensitive area. So even palpating those or kneading those or giving soft tissue release had helps in releasing all the symptoms that are coming from that specific. Like it basically reduces the excessive sympathetic output related to it. So in this one, you can see that there is like the greater in the femur, you can see this, there is the cecum related, the mid shaft is related to the ascending colon, the distal one is the for the hepatic fixture. That's related to the right and left. In right, you can see the cecum. It's related to our body, how the system is. Like the cecum is on the right side. So the right leg, you can see there is a cecum, the ascending colon and hepatic flexure. On the left leg, you can see the sigmoid, descending colon and the splenic flexures in this. And there is anterior Chapman point and there is posterior Chapman point. So the posterior Chapman point is a triangular area which it's between the L2 vertebrae and L4 vertebrae, and it's connected to this iliac spine, the iliac bone. You can see this area. So by needling, like kneading, you can do the kneading, you can give the soft tissue massage, or you can give even muscle energy technique, which really helps. It has shown a significant improvement for the excessive sympathetic output has been reduced in this cases, in this one, in related to the Chapman points.
Right.
Yes, ma'am.
Right, sir. Very nice. And the main thing, lymphatic drainage, how it works and it affects all the system related constipation to thyroid and thyroid to constipation. You have mentioned that lymphatic drainage also plays a role. So how you will combine all these things?
So first of all, when we are starting the lymphatic drainage starts from the releasing the thoracolumbar thoracic area first. So we'll start with the thoracic area, then go towards the lower first half. Like we'll release all the lower. We'll take from abdomen to thorax will bring. We'll bring, because the azygous vein is in the center of the body. So what we'll do is like we'll take, we are giving a thoracic inlet pump. We are using the thoracic inlet pump. Then we are taking it into between the body, into the azygous vein. Then we are doing the diaphragmatic pump and the petal pump. That will take all the lymphatic drainage towards the center of the body. And we are doing the cervical limb drainage. Like we'll do the cervical limb drainage, the mandibular and the submandibular release in this. And the last will do the great abdominal release and also the diaphragmatic pump again. So this is the protocol that I have used for the lymphatic drainage in this case, ma'am.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Right, sir. Over to you, sir.
Yeah, first and foremost, definitely not only effort to prepare content are the slides. Okay? The slides were also visually communicative. Okay. And of course, it's interest to directly interact. See, otherwise, usually students are even qualified professionals. Somebody asks a question, they will not start with the answer. They'll first ask like, sir, can I answer? Okay. He's like, immediately he's directly is addressing. Okay, it shows that, okay, so that the hard work, okay, the fruit of the hard work that is there inside, okay? It's yet to ripe, but it is still there. And another thing is, of course, that systematic way of, you know, if there is a query means I'll project it and I will explain, okay? He could have just told verbally, you know, there are points in the ITB here and there, okay, according to Chapman. He would have just told that. But he wanted to ensure that people should get that information and knowledge. Okay? So these things definitely go a long way in making a person, okay, the best. Okay. Of course, I will tell you my thing slide by slide. Okay. First and foremost, the title, patient, you are using a single word, okay? And don't use the word patient, use it like adults with constipation, okay? So you put the slide, can you, Rishabh?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
And don't bother about writing down now because you can see the video again. Okay. So you can actually see the inputs.
Sure.
I want you to understand the importance of the changes. Effect, effects. Okay. Plural. And treatment on constipation or on scoring quality of life and thyroid stimulating hormone levels. Okay. Remember, when you use the word effects, it is telling effect on what. Okay. You cannot tell you are curing constipation. We are only getting changes in the scores. We are only getting changes in the hormonal values. We are only getting changes in the quality of life measure. Okay. So when you are using effects, effects is the appropriate word. So you have to tell the outcomes, all the three outcomes in the title. Okay. Your title will become longer, but still we have to specify. Otherwise, it should be efficacy of osteopathic manipulative treatment. I will prefer that word, osteopathic manipulative treatment, because that is globally used in the recent literature. OMT, osteopathic manipulative treatment. Okay. Efficacy of osteopathic manipulative treatment on constipation in adults with hypothyroidism. Okay. So that is one option. Other one is effects of osteopathic manipulative treatment on quality of life or the stool scoring, okay, Bristol stool score, and TSH levels, the thyroid stimulating hormone, full form it has to come, okay, in the title, levels in adults with hyperthyroidism, hypothyroidism, okay. So better to change it into efficacy, make it, keep it shorter.
Yes, sir.
Sure. And then you have to mention the design also. You should tell that every post quasi experimental study, okay, or you have to tell that, okay. So yes, the design, yes, must be mentioned in the title, because it can be a randomized clinical trial, it can be cohort. So there are a lot of even retrospective study as you got in literature. Okay.
Yes, sir.
You can also review the literature and see retrospectively, okay, who all have improved. Okay. So, and the patient word should not be used, because the WHO guideline that people, okay, in adults with children with elderly with, okay, that language should come. Okay. So these changes in the title. Next slide.
This is the.
Table of contents. Here, this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, you have showed it like a serial number. Okay. Yes. You better show the slide number. Okay. It's like the page number. Okay.
Okay, sir. Okay, sir.
So I want you to number each and every slide. First thing is slide number. Insert the number for the slides. After that, put that numbers here. Okay?
Yes, sir. Sure, sir.
Idea is, people who are attending the presentation can note down that it is slide number 20, I have a query. Okay?
Okay, sir.
So you can directly go to that part and then you can discuss. Okay? So every presentation, the slide number will come in the picture. Next slide. Here, introduction is fine. Objectives, literature review, methodology. Tools are there. No. Go back to the table of contents. You have put tools. Tools are actually part of the methodology only. Okay. Usually, yes, that word methodology means that the tools, outcomes, all that. Objective is actually part of the introduction. But still, it is fine. But you can include one more term, aim and objectives.
Okay, yeah? Sir. Okay, sir.
The title will be the aim. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Like the overall aim of seeing the efficacy in constipation. Okay? As an adjunctive treatment. Because you have to mention that word adjunctive in addition to the standard medical management and yoga. Okay? So this should come not in the title, but in the aim, okay? And objective, you can put each outcome measure wise, like OMT on stool score, OMT on TSH levels, OMT on constipation quality of life, okay? So each one will be one objective, okay?
Yes, sir, sure, sir.
This is okay, introduction, yeah, research question. More than research question is statement of problem. There is a word, it's like, I have hunger, okay? Where am I going to have the food is the research question, okay?
Yes, sir.
But the hunger is the major problem. So you have to tell the missing literature, the missing link in the literature, okay? And the lack of Indian population, okay, application and all that, okay? The combination, what you have actually thought of from the literature has not been studied before, okay? All these missing gaps in the literature will be actually called as statement of problem, okay? So what you should tell is the first half, the first sentence is actually the statement of problem. Okay. Hypothyroidism reduces the intestinal motility and leads to constipation. If it is untreated, okay, then this becomes like this. Okay. There are studies telling the efficacies individually on people with the hypothyroidism or osteopathic manipulative treatment on constipation. But study examining the effect of the OMT in constipation for constipation in hypothyroidism is scarce. Okay. So that will highlight the statement of problem. Okay. When you say research question, yes, osteopathy can it be used to treat constipation. The second sentence which you are telling, present study is intended to know, it is actually the aim. Okay.
Yes, sir.
But you are stating it as a question. What will be the effect of this in treating in the age group? Okay. Next slide. See, remember that research question you have put after the introduction and then the background is coming. Background comes first. Okay. After background is research question.
Okay, sure.
Okay. First, it's the existing literature. Then you tell gap in the literature. That is statement of problem. And what do we do for that gap? You are raising that thought process. That is a research question. Okay.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
And then hypothesis is what you are expecting out of it. Okay. Like it will provide an additional benefit over yoga and standard medical management. Okay. Standard care of medical management or pharmacological management. So, hypothyroidism reduce the gut mobility and quality of life. You use the word quality of life as much as possible. Okay. So, in the intersection area that circles, you can put reduced gut mobility, impaired nutrition, okay, and reduced quality of life. Okay, so you can put all the three in the middle. So it will show that the importance of this overlapping is more important than individual problem. Okay, in hypothyroidism, you include other than this digestion and elimination, other effects of hypothyroidism, you put in the green circle. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Slowed digestion and slowed elimination, you put in the common area only, up only.
Okay.
Okay? Because yes, it comes in both the sides mix. Hmm?
Yes,
whichever
sir.
Is both the sides, it should come in the middle. Hypothyroidism affects alone on the human body, that you put in the green area, independently there. Huh? So, next slide. Here you have to put that aim and then objectives, okay, as highlighted. Modify the wording. Next slide. The specific objectives actually come as the objectives. As you have listed like primary objective, this is secondary objectives, okay. That's another terminology. But I would suggest aim is to see the efficacy of OMT as an adjunctive treatment to yoga and standard care of medical management for people with constipation and hypothyroidism. Okay. So that is the aim. Objective is to study the effect of OMT on the TSH levels in the sample population. Okay. Because don't repeat hypothyroidism constipation again and again. By listening to that, people will get either constipation or hypothyroidism. Okay. So make sure that you tell that in our sample, in our study population. Okay. Mention those words. OMT, when you are using First time when you are telling osteopathic manipulative treatment, after that OMT, OMT, OMT alone is enough. Okay.
Yes, sir.
TSH, if this is the first area where it is coming, you have to put it in full brackets TSH or below the slide, the bottom line, you can put TSH means hyphen thyroid stimulating hormone. Okay. So any kind of an abbreviation, you can explain it in the bottom line in the same slide. Okay. Slide numbering again. Okay. So next slide. Review of literature, literature review. Make sure that the year of publication is important. Okay. Whenever you are reviewing, people would be interested to know. Andrew Taylor still, 1876 or whichever. Okay. But if you see 1854, maybe. Okay. And others, if you see 2010, after that, the articles which are there are really very important than the ones which is 1980, 90. Okay.
Yes, sir.
And you have subheadings. You put that, studies on hypothyroidism, constipation in hypothyroidism. Okay. Studies on OMT for constipation. Studies on OMT for hypothyroidism. Independently, it will be there. Okay.
Yes.
So you might combine both because we want to treat the patient, not just the constipation. We want to treat the hypothyroidism also. Okay. For us, patient is important. Okay. That's why yoga, the psychosocial or the other systemic effects. Okay. Pharmacological management will take care of the chemical and the electrolyte. Okay. That aspects. And you are taking care of the viscerosomatic and the somatovisceral. Okay. So you have to group the studies under subheadings. And in each subheading, first list the study which is old study, like 2010 study. You put Unnikrishnan and bracket 2012. K.I. Dean et al. 2015. Okay. Yes, Pustarino et al. Okay. 2019. Okay. So that means the latest study comes last. Okay. So it is like historical review right from beginning till the end on that focused topic, the subheading. Okay. So organize like that. You have left the gap. Is it for some picture?
Yes, sir. Sir, for picture only, sir.
These things ensure that.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Not be there.
Yes, sir. Sure, sir.
Next. Points as much as possible avoid in the literature review. Okay. If, for example, you are putting these asanas, you want to show the pictures, it is part of the methodology, use it in the pictures there. Okay. Standard care. You tell what are the medications and you mention that the prescription will be given as per the physician. Okay. Their decision. And we are not going to interfere with that. We are not going to tell the patient that don't take, discontinue the medications. Okay. Or we are not going to modify the yoga schedule or the, so you can put it in methodology if you want to explain this. You can put here the studies on yoga. Okay. Then group them according to the date. Okay. With the author name, the year has to come in brackets. Next slide. Next section. Next. Even you need that Bristol stool score reliability validity. Okay. And the constipation specific quality of life. Okay.
Okay, sir. Yes,
that
sir,
also
yes,
reliability sir. Validity. One sir. Study at least you need.
Okay. Yes, sir.
Outcome
sir,
measure. How reliable and valid they are. Okay. So for that TSH level, normative value and categorizing like mild, moderate, severe hypothyroidism, depending upon TSH. Okay.
Yes, sir. Yes. Yes.
That also is needed there. And you have to tell that when you are telling in exclusion criteria, you have to tell severe hypothyroidism, you will exclude. Okay. If TSH value is more than this one. Okay. Right?
Yes, sir. Yes. Yes, sir.
And here, in that, or whatever hypothyroidism, so TSH value is below this value, okay, and then you will not include. In the inclusion criteria, the gender always mentioned either male or female. Okay. Both gender is not possible.
Yes.
Okay. How will you choose the subjects? Okay. You have a hospital. Yes?
Yes, sir.
First you tell that the, you know, public awareness information leaflets will be circulated in and around the campus. Okay.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
And the next one is a news release or a article will be published in the local newspaper advertising that we have a treatment option so that people will come to the campus. Okay. And the other third category is people who already visit the hospital and the physician have screened that and they have referred to the Department of Osteopathy, okay, for treatment. Okay. So three categories.
Sure, sir.
You will choose, but how will you choose? Okay. How do you know that they have constipation? How do they know that they have hypothyroidism? So you have to tell that we publish an article, we circulate information leaflets so that they will come and contact. Okay. So convenient sampling, that word, replace it by purposive sampling. Okay.
Yes,
you
sir,
have
yes,
a criteria, sir. Inclusion, exclusion criteria.
Yeah.
So
yes.
Best word is criteria based purposive sampling. Okay. Cranial, musculoskeletal, and visceral techniques, constipation. Dependent variables, you put the constipation, quality of life. Why is it not coming in this?
Yes, sir.
Independent, that word has to be one only. Okay, in the center, don't break it. Okay, if you are breaking it, put the hyphen in.
Yes,
hyphen.
Sir, yes, sir.
Next line, sure. Dependent hyphen. Procedure. Yeah, procedure. Go to the procedure. In the procedure, there is a thing called as consort. Okay, CONSORT. Okay, consort flow diagram. Okay, for the what is called as what you have shown flow chart. Okay, the same but different format is there. Okay,
yes,
first
sir.
One I would say subjects contacted. Okay, next is subjects consented. How many people gave consent? Okay, and then subjects screened, inclusion exclusion criteria. Okay, subjects,
yes,
included. Okay. After that, pre-test outcome assessment. Okay. Then intervention. How many received the intervention? Next is post-test outcome measurement. How many completed the study? Because some people would have taken only 3 sessions, 4th session onwards, gayab. Okay. Usually happens in our Indian scenario. If they improve very well also, they will not come. They are not feeling any changes also, they will not come. Mm-hmm. Suddenly, for any unknown reason, subject will stop coming. Okay.
Yes,
so, that is considered as a dropout. Okay. Dropouts. So, data analysis, final interpretation. Okay. Analysis is only once only. Final. Okay.
Yes,
next slide. Sympathetic, parasympathetic. You tell me, constipation is because of sympathetic overactivation or parasympathetic overactivation?
It is due to sympathetic, sir.
If it is due to sympathetic, why are people getting diarrhea when they are stressed? They are not getting constipation.
Overactive,
the external anal sphincter.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Is voluntary.
Voluntary
internal anal sphincter, yes, is supplied by parasympathetic. that is activation will produce contraction of the sphincter, which will close the sphincter. If you are relaxed, the sphincters are closed, including urethral and anal. Okay, parasympathetic nervous system is overactive, means this is the scenario. If you are telling vagal mechanism as your hypothesis, you should tell I am desensitizing the vagus. Okay, we are actually what is called as we are doing some interventions which will actually provoke the symptoms initially. Okay, and because it's a combination of intervention together with lymphatic drainage and visceral manipulation, everything, so we are getting a effect which will silence the vagus hyperactivity. Okay, see, one thing, if in heart also vagus is parasympathetic, so it actually slows down the heartbeat.
Yes, okay?
So if you are addressing the vagus, don't you think that patients will develop bradycardia, or with hypothyroidism will they not have associated cardiac changes or hypertension? Okay, these things are some things which are tough to answer. Okay, you just keep it outside your domain and use it for discussion after the research is ended. Okay.
Yes, sir. Sure, sir.
As of now, what you try to see is we are going systematically. We are trying to prepare the tissues by fascia release. We are lengthening the adaptive soft tissue length, okay, the tightening or the adhesions with muscle energy techniques. Sympathetic treatment is actually we are preparing or we are desensitizing, whichever, because this is the first which actually reacts to any kind of a treatment is sympathetic. Okay. So in cervical spine also there is a celiac plexus, okay, C6-7. So that is also another important area, which may be cervical spine functional malalignments, okay, can influence. There are other techniques in manual therapy like neurodynamic techniques, neural mobilizations. These involve sympathetic slump. No, there are even parasympathetic also. Vagus nerve neurodynamic test and vagus nerve or neural mobilization. Okay, there is a literature also. Okay, I am not asking you to include neural mobilization, but make sure that these things are in your mind so that discussion you can tell. Okay, future research could be done combining these techniques also. Okay, something like that. Mm-hmm. Lymphatic drainage is essential, because it determines the fluid transport. Okay, visceral manipulation is mechanically important for the viscera. Okay, so that is also very important. Parasympathetic or sympathetic, which one will come first? Okay, just session 3 can be parasympathetic or session 6 can be sympathetic. Okay, take an opinion of a osteopathic expert. Okay, as I suggested in the first part, that communication with the authors of the articles, okay, the reference articles.
Yes, yes, sir.
So get an opinion through the email, so that you can have solid backup telling that I discussed with the expert and he also suggested this only, that this sequence of third day sympathetic is better than sixth day parasympathetic, whichever. Okay. Next slide. Yeah, these are okay. But in this, you also mentioned the day. Okay. Which day, okay, you are giving this?
Yes, sir.
And
yes,
how, sir, many minutes you are giving? Okay.
Okay. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Sure, sir.
Or repetitions. Okay. The stroke direction as you have marked. I think those directions are already there in the textbook. Okay. So in the pictures, which are the arrows are not there, you have to mark the arrows. Next. Yeah. Okay. In the day-wise flowchart, okay, you have not listed the techniques. Okay, Otherwise, there in that flow chart also, here itself, fascia release, then list the techniques. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Lymphatic part, drainage, then lift the, raise the, what to say, pump techniques, all of them you list. Visceral, sigmoid lift and all those things. So like that you list here.
Yes, sir.
That later it will be known that. And session you have mentioned alternate is, right?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So 3 sessions in a week. So you're going to treat for 2 weeks. If a session is missed by the subject, you will still include, you will take them. But if they miss more than 2 sessions, like they don't come alternate days, they come the 3rd day, suddenly 4th day. Okay. Any home program given to the subjects other than yoga and medications? Think of that also. Okay. What treatment the subject can do at home, specifically related to OMT?
Yes. So I have planned for this Vegas. There is a exercise which I prescribe to every patient who comes to my clinic for this vagal release. There is a technique in which we use oculo vagal release, which we are using. We are using eyes for releasing the movement of eyes for releasing the vagus nerve. So there is a technique which I prescribe to each and every patient. They can do at home whenever before sleep while.
Do a workup. See for evidence and then incorporate.
Okay. Yes, sir. Yes.
Next slide. Stools, constipation. The clear, the yellow font changing to something else, blue, purple, something contrasting. Okay. The name of the.
Sure. Yes.
Next slide. The back QOL, go back. The back QOL should be full form. Why you have put like abbreviation? First time you are using this word here in the whole presentation.
Yes, I'll give the full form. Yes, sir. Sure, sir.
Patient assessment of constipation, quality of life.
Quality of life. Yes, sir.
Next. Data analysis, Excel don't mention. Okay.
Okay, sir.
As you have told the statistical package, you tell pre-post comparisons for all the outcome measures will be done using students' t-test. Okay. And there is a measure also for that statistics called as confidence interval. So arbitrarily it is used at 95% confidence interval. Okay. After analysis, we see the probability of error in terms of p-value. So p-value is less than 5%. 5% means 0.05.
Okay.
So less than 0.05, then we tell significant effect. Okay. So that means error is less than 5%. So the study findings are significant. Initially, before the study, we tell confidence interval 95%. Okay. So you will have to mention that pre-post comparison of all outcome measures will be analyzed using students' t-test. Or you use paired t-test. Okay. Why paired t-test? Because pre and post is considered as a pair. Unpaired t-test means you compare people with hypothyroidism without hypothyroidism. Okay. If at all you are doing such a study. Okay. Between groups. Or one group who received only medical management and yoga. Another group who received the osteopathic manipulative treatment. Okay. If you are comparing between groups, then the unparity test comes. Okay. So in your study, it is not between groups. Okay. It is same. So parity test. Okay. At 95% confidence interval using SPSS for windows. correct the spellings. Okay, statistical. Statistical, not statistical. Okay. Next.
Sorry, sir.
It comes. More spelling mistakes are coming towards the end, actually. References, I have told you the format for the journal articles.
Yes, sir.
So maintain that. PMID and all, no need. Don't use references which are French and Italian. If you are using, that means mention that it is only the abstract. Okay. There's no point in referring an Italian article and French article full text. Okay. When you don't understand A to Z of anything. Next. JMPT. What is the reference? Yeah. Tasuslu. Children with cerebral palsy. Children's studies mostly avoid. Okay. You see, adults only constipation, OMT, so many studies are there. Don't use out of the population. Next one. Thank you, slide. You can also put the questionnaire, the PAC quality of life. Okay. Or consent form.
Yes, sir.
Consent what you are actually going to do to the patient.
Yes, sir.
So that should be there. Another is patient education or information sheet. Generally awareness promoting, okay, about constipation, about diet, about active lifestyle, relaxation and stress management, okay. Only one page with pictures and descriptions, so that patients who are participating in your study should get some benefit of education.
Okay. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Sure, sir. I like
so
this.
That way.
Yes, sir. Yes.
These
sir.
Are ethical issues. Okay, so when you present to ethics committee, they will ask for consent form. They will ask for whether you are translating the questionnaire, okay, into the local Odia language, okay. And then the next thing, of course, they will talk about what is the benefit that the patient is getting by participating in your study, other than being part of a new knowledge, okay. Are you going to give free treatment? Yes, of course, you can tell that it's a charity institution. Our hospital is providing free treatment for all the patients. Okay. Another one you have to tell, side effects. If the patient says that it's worsening, what will be your next plan of action? So you will have to tell that we'll pause the intervention. Okay. And we'll give them with alternate treatments. Okay. As per the directions of the physician. Okay. And we'll analyze that as patient having adverse event. Okay. So you have to tell this, although in reality, nobody does that. Okay. If somebody is not improving, what they do is they exclude that patient. Okay. And then they take the next patient, whoever is improving only, they count in the final study. Okay.
Yes.
You have told sample size 30, that is enough. Okay. That is good. No problem. For a t-test, you actually need 32. Okay. So somehow try to see that also 5 people will eventually drop out. Okay. Whatever yes, you are considering as yes, sample size. So 40, you tell 8 dropouts, 5%, 20% dropout. Okay. 8 people will disappear. Okay. And 32 you will get for the statistical requirement for the t-test is 32. Okay. So you can tell that as a reason. As of now, this is the thing which you can actually incorporate, okay, and see that the expert discussion is important, okay.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Even the constipation quality of life, that author also contact, tell that I am going to translate into Odia language. I require your permission. Simply, they will tell, no, it's already free, no problem, you can use it. But just to put that email screenshots in the appendix, the last with the consent form, with the questionnaire, everything. okay, information leaflet. With that on screenshot, communication with the Brookman. Okay. You cannot tell communication with process and field. Okay. But what's important is the global authorities. Okay.
Yes.
So put it like that so that it gives more value for projects. Okay. That the work that you do. Okay. The validity of the scientific thought. Okay. Like that. Right.
Yes.
Now, Rishabh has any questions?
No, sir. All the doubts have been cleared, sir. So, thank you, sir, for correcting me, sir, for this. All the.
Now, leave me alone, sir. I will go and take rest, have some coffee and samosa. Yeah. Now, I don't know. One thing I'll tell you, 10% of this only will come in the college presentation. Okay. I am not undersizing the effort of the faculty there. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Most of the times what happens is the schedule, like 50 students are there. So 5 days the presentations will be there.
Mm-hmm.
10 students in a day. Okay. 6 hours of full-time concentration on the LCD projector and the presenter. 6 hours. If it is there, or 5 hours, it is there. One student, half an hour. If you are presenting for 25 minutes as you did today, 5 minutes only will be there for discussion. If it is equal for everybody.
Yes, sir.
What I assume is your alphabetical letter, which is R. Okay. So it will come second or third day. Okay. First day pending also will be taken second day. Okay. Some students, mostly after lunch, they will not take the presentation.
Yes, sir.
Because there will be special lunch which will be ordered for the faculty, okay, during these kind of presentations. And after special lunch, you know, they cannot sit for presentation at all. Okay, if they sit also, morning 5 presentations will be little bit more deeper. Later 5 will be like, go to methodology. All the changes which we told, third student, the first student, this one, that you note down, that you interpret. So it will move on like that. Okay. So afterwards, if you go separately to the faculty, they will tell that already we told in the presentation. What is there? That alone is enough. Okay. So everything will happen. It's part of the reality. But the people who are authors who have published will very patiently answer you. Okay.
Yes,
just tell that this is the article which I have read and I am doing a research project. So I want to discuss with you. Upon your consent, I will send my queries.
Okay,
okay, so this
yes,
should be
yes,
the
sir.
First email. Don't send the queries straight away. Okay. Then next, they will tell that, happy to know that you are doing your research. Please share the findings with us also. Okay, we'll be excited to know what you got. Okay. So try to see that. And in future, we can publish in a global language, who knows, with them as a co-author. Okay, so because they were there right from the beginning, okay, so they will also be happy to co-author, and that is how you get your name in the world. Okay, right?
Yes, sir.
You are not just in India. You are not just in Sri. You are in AOIMPT, so that means you are for the world.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So, what truth, ma'am? So, good luck to you, and keep coming up with updates, and see that Zoom discussion we can have post your presentation in your college if they suggest some changes, whether that changes is needed or not. Okay, we can have, right?
Sure, sir.
And if it is not needed, what you will do is you will have backup of the international authors, osteopaths. Okay.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
What I tell points, discuss those points with the global people.
Yes, sir. Okay. I have planned. Yes,
they
sir.
Will agree. Okay. They yes. will tell the same. Then you can tell their name. Okay. Don't tell my name. And the next thing is, make sure that the English, the spelling, the grammar things check. Okay.
Yes,
if there
yes,
is a
sure.
your parallel batchmate who's you know, better in English, always do it to them. Let them do the proofreading for English. Okay. Or yourself also, read it from last to the front. Okay. You will read the last slide first, then read the next before slide. Reverse. Then you will see the spelling mistake. Okay. When you are reading from the beginning, you already have the thinking process, and that is the thinking process in that direction you made the slides. So you will not find any mistakes. Okay. In life also, when we look back and see our past, then we know that we have done a mistake. We are looking forward, we are not aware. Okay, what mistakes we should not do. So, take care. I will unmute Dr. Ritu and Dr. Mansi to give the closing words, and then we can wind up. Yes, over to Dr. Ritu.
Yes, sir. It was nice information and question answers, and that how you are added the information, which were very informative, that how we have to start with the title, where we have to write that there, you have mentioned that no need to write the particular patient word. This is very unique. This, we have to write the adults and children. Then we have to sequel way. We have to make the slide numbering, everything. If the, where is the introduction, that aim and objective in compared to tools where you have mentioned, and that the main thing, when we are made, and one thing which I want to say, that whenever we made slides and the title, I think it should be in a bold letters, not in a Italian way or in a cursive writing. So it gives more approachable, because when you open the slide and first impression is the title. So if it is italic, sometimes we have to pay the attention like this. If it is clear in a bold letter, that it gives a good impression to the...
Even in the literature review also, some words alone, you can make it bold, bold.
Yeah, okay? Right, sir.
Yes, sir.
So that people will read only those words.
Huh? Yeah.
Yes, sir. Sure, sir.
Don't allow viewers to read fully. You have to direct them what you want them to read, that only they have to read. So put that bold one. So it will make things easier for you.
Yeah, because how much the slide will be simple, it will be easy for the reading or for the understanding of the person who is reading in a first time. Maybe he has no more time, but if it is simple, he can step by step, he can easily read. If you will write in a different manner, then maybe sometimes they don't want to spend more time on reading that slide. And the particular how you are writing, that background you were showing, that is, I think simplicity is the best. I think when we make some research project or anything, we make that is the simplicity. And overall, sir has already explained in a very easy way that how we can make our research project and how we can present, and where we have to mention the abstracts and where we have to mention the references of the author. So, and where we have to, sometimes we can add some little bit pictorial graph, which can give more. If you are don't want to read, then you can see the diagrams and pictorial graph. That also gives a very presentable. It looks presentable and gives a very good
for
look.
What, ma'am?
No, sir. Like that, they have made the space they have left for their pictures. No, then there he can mention that some pictures like of the patient, the comparison study. With the exercises like yoga versus osteopathy, that you can make some tables also, that also gives a better representation way. Not pictorial graph, that is a wrong word I have.
Because he already used all the pictorial graphs. Okay?
Yeah.
You saw right. That he was using everything with flowcharts and pictures.
Yeah. So it's a overall presentation, and when you will correct it, and I think...
He can use... other type of presentation with fully pictures, if he is having 50 patients with constipation and hypothyroidism who have come after his newspaper article, yes, or after circulating the information leaflets, he has given a particular time, this particular Sunday you come, okay? All the patients will be getting lunch, free lunch, okay? Yoga lunch, okay? Not the full-fledged lunch. all the healthy line, healthy diet, okay, for your intestine. Okay, so like that. It's anyway, it's institution always is ready to sponsor for patients because they are getting a lot of money from the students. Okay, so there is no problem at all for the patients or the students. Okay, so for that, anything the institution will provide. So in conjunction with the medical superintendent of the hospital, okay, we'll be very happy to give press release and publicize the hospital. Definitely it is possible. When they are coming, 50 people are sitting, that time you can use a PowerPoint with more pictures, no text at all. Okay. And treatment techniques also, if it is videos, it is good. 2-3 patients, if you have got improvements, okay, if 2-3 patients have got improved, take a video testimonial. Okay, the patient themselves talking right, that I came, took the treatment and I got better. Okay. So these things, Sri Sri marketing team will take care. Local news, in between it will come. Okay, clippings will come. Patients will be Dr. Rishabh, Dr. Rishabh. Okay. They'll be lining up in the queue. So you have to make the people come to you. Okay?
Yes, sir.
It's all, lot of things are possible.
Right, sir. Very true.
Right.
When these words are coming from Sir mouth, na, then it will be definitely, it will be sure, it will be happen. Because when the teacher gives the blessings, na, so it really wonderfully it works. Sir is saying it means you will rock. Thank you, sir. Thank you, Rishabh. A very nice session. And thank overall, we have learned many more new things from this session, which we were not in our mind, but now yes, we can think more about all these things, and we will wait for your next presentation when you will come with your more presentation. Definitely. So good luck to you for your work.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Over to you, sir.
As an incentive that Rishabh presented this, and I'm going to give him the osteopathic, the 10 webinars free. Okay, so 10 topics of osteopathy which we took, including visceral osteopathy and other techniques.
Yeah.
So Rishabh will receive it absolutely free.
Yeah, very nice session that was. We enjoyed that session very much. That was full of the different way of osteopathy you have. I don't know that you are learning more about in your college, but when you will see the osteopathic session from AOMPT and from Sir, then you will see the change of what is real. It's my written words that you can note it. And when you will see, then you will automatically, you will feel the difference. It's a really a wonderful topic. And how sir have means, we in our osteopathic webinars, and then we see the hand movement, but the how sir has connected all the theory while explaining all the things. Sir, when sir was keeping the hand that place, that it means we were feeling the same feel we were gaining, that how we can give the osteopathy technique to the patient for their betterment. Although we are not aware of so much that time before the session of AOMPT of osteopathy, but after that, yes, we have learned a lot, and you will definitely, you will more learn because you are in a same boat, so you will learn more than us. So good luck to you. Thank you. Thank you to you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yes, sir.
Dr. Mansi, ma'am.
Yes, sir. I think this should be the best evening for Dr. Rishabh, I guess, because you have a keen eye, sir. You have detailed out everything in one go. I mean, the spelling mistakes also, what to include, what to exclude. I think it was very interesting to listen to that too. And all the best to you. And whatever sir has said, of course, it will happen. And nothing, sir. All the best. Thank you so much, sir. See, all these things are very new to me. It was a very new thing that I have heard, I have encountered. And listening to sir post, I mean, your presentation, how he has corrected you, I mean, it is wonderful. It is really good. All the points to include, to exclude the children's thing so that you are not bombarded with extra questions. Then to include the backup of the authors who have done the who have done this osteopathy on patients, I think that will be a solid backup for you. You might get extra points for it if you have it, if you have a telephonic or whatever email conversation with them. So I think all these points will really help you a lot. All good, sir. Thank you so much.
Mansi forgot to tell the reality, what I told. 10 students in a day, after lunch they will not take. You know, that also people have to be prepared. Because yes, what happens is unnecessary stress for the students. Yes. They think like, oh, presentation. Okay. And in reality,
nothing happens.
For this, why are we suffering too much like this? Like, so
yes,
you should know that the extreme also. You should not get frustrated also seeing that. Okay. That's the way things move on. Everybody, we have crossed all those stages. And we do our work. Okay. It is only for the value of knowledge we are doing the work. We are not doing for anybody to appreciate our what is called as
correct
the rewards. Okay, we are doing it for way of life. Okay, so that should be the level of commitment and compassion. Compassion towards patients, passion towards the profession, and target excellence. Okay. So good luck to you, Rishabh. So we close the session with permission of Dr. Mansi and Dr. Ritu.
Thank you, everyone. Thank you.
See you.
Bye, sir. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you. Sir. Thank you so much. Thanks to you. Thank you, sir. Bye, Ritu, ma'am. Thank you.
Bye.